Hello everyone and welcome back to Let's Play Deus Ex Human Revolution. Last time when we left off, Malik had just been shot down at the start of our second visit to Hengsha. So let's load that up. Chapter 12, Peeling Back the Curtain. Jensen returned to Detroit, intending to confront Seraph and track down Eliza's second lead, but tensions between normal and augmented humans had reached a flashpoint. Riots had erupted in several cities.
Malik, we've got...
And I need to read all that, so...
Oh. Malik, we've got...
Oh, come on. I think it's gonna force me to exit the game and reboot it if I want to read all that stuff.
Malik, we've got company.
I know, but the bird took some damage.
Yeah, let's just do that. Sorry, just trying to read the chapter descriptions. Riots had erupted in several cities and the UN was being urged to intervene. Seraph admitted that the scientists were taken by the Illuminati. You know what, let me just Google this on my laptop right quick. Because I'm tired of... having to reload because the game doesn't let you read those outside the load screen. Well, let me do this one more time. Probably because of research they'd been conducting. Then he urged Jensen to get his people back, handing him a ticket to a Humanity Front convention.
Malik,
and I still haven't done the newest chapter, chapter 13. Just get it to happen. Doesn't look like it. I think I had already read chapter 12, which makes it even sillier, but... 13. Fallen Soldiers. Determined to locate Seraph's scientists, Jensen tracked down Isaiah Sandoval, personal assistant to America's most outspoken augmentation opponent. Good lord, but that goes fast. Sandoval admitted to operating on the scientists in hopes of disabling their implanted tracking devices, but refused to implicate his boss, Bill Taggart.
Malik, we've...
We're close now. At least there's that. I can't find these online either. Pritchard then traced one of the scientists' signals back to China, sending Jensen and Malik scrambling to find him. Unfortunately, the conspirators were still one step ahead.
Malik, we've got company.
I know.
Okay. M2, find Vasily Savchenko's GPL device. Primary objectives, escape the construction site. Malik and I were flying to Hengsha to find one of the missing scientists when Chinese authorities forced us into a Belltower ambush. Malik can't escape until she fixes the chopper, but if I stay and protect her, I might not get out of here alive. Now let me talk about what to do about Malik. First, saving her is worth an achievement. I think it's probably the hardest achievement in the game to get, but I'm gonna save her first off just to get the achievement Good Soul. That said, in terms of actual gameplay, we want to let Malik die for a couple of reasons. First, you get more experience here because once she's dead, the soldiers eventually settle down and return to their normal patrols, and we can get rid of them with double takedowns. The second is that if she's alive and shows up later, she kills some people which we could otherwise take down, and we lose some experience there too. So, what we're going to do is first take care of the guys to get the Good Soul achievement, and I'll go ahead and not worry about killing them, because I'm just going to reload and let Malik die and proceed that way. So, that said, let's get started.
Oh, but the bird took some damage. Gonna need to patch it up before I can go.
I usually like to start by hucking a few gas grenades.
Negative. You need to get away from here and find Dr. Savchenko. I'll be fine.
You'll be a sitting duck.
Maybe, maybe not. But this is your best chance to slip by them unnoticed, and you know it. So get out of here, Jensen.
Well, let's just typhoon. That was close, but you can see how tough it is to save her.
Malik, we've got company.
I know, but the bird took...
Let's try again. Start with a gas grenade.
Some damage. Gonna need to patch it up before I can go.
Two of them, maybe.
I'll stay and cover you.
Negative. You need to get away from here and find Dr. Savchenko. I'll be fine.
You'll be a sitting duck.
Maybe, maybe not.
This is your best chance to slip by them unnoticed, and you know it. So get out of here, Jensen.
Jensen, the bird's fixed and I'm taking off. Now get on with the damned mission. And thanks, spy boy.
Okay, so we saved her. We got Good Soul. Against all odds, you saved Farida Malik's life. That's 35 out of 49 achievements, 71%. And, like I said, it's... even possible to do it non-lethally and preserving Ghost, But what is really not possible to do is get it with all of the double takedowns that are necessary to maximize our experience. So the best thing we can do is let her die, experience-wise. And now that we have the achievement, that's what we're going to do.
Malik, we've got company.
I know, but the bird took some damage. Gonna need to patch it up before I can go.
I'll stay and cover you.
Negative! You need to get away from here and find Dr. Savchenko. I'll be fine.
You'll be a sitting duck.
Maybe, maybe not. But this is your best chance to slip by them unnoticed, and you know it. So get out of here, Jensen.
No, I'm just gonna wait for them to take it down. It'll happen fast if I leave those guys with the heavy rifles alive.
Hey, Jensen.
Malik? Malik, you hurt?
Just a scratch, spy boy. But I think... I think you're on your own now.
Rita.
Give him hell for me.
Okay. Now, if I remember right, these guys eventually settle down and go to what you'd call their normal patrols. Oh yeah, see, I enabled the cooldown timer. It's showing me the 80 seconds I have. Forty more seconds. Then everyone will settle down and we can start arranging double takedowns. There are 10 guys out here, and there is a ghost bonus attached to getting out unseen. So I might actually want to get that first. There are 10 guys plus the one box guard. And then naturally, since this is a new area, you can't access this construction site on your first visit to Hengsha. You'll want to loot it, explore it, poke around, all that good stuff. Anyway. Yeah, I'm gonna get the ghost bonus before I do anything else. I'm just gonna start sneaking out of here.
You see anything? If anyone's here, come out now.
I think you're seeing.
The good news is we can get back here after leaving.
Jensen, I've been monitoring comm activity around Hengsha. Belltower's looking for you. Hard.
Bastards ambushed us, Pritchard. Malik didn't make it.
Oh God. I know you might want to get even. But if they see you, if they recognize you, it might be better to stay out of their way.
There it is. Getting things done, 1,000. Ghost, 500. For a total of 1,500. Find Vasily Savchenko's GPL device. The only GPL signal that Pritchard was able to track suggests that Vasily Savchenko is somewhere in the Yutsao district of Lower Hengsha. Finding him should be as simple as tracing the signal back to its source. Before we do that, let me just show you where we've come out. Oh yeah, okay, it's an it is a different area. There's an exit to Lower Hengsha. And there's not really anything going on up here. So now, we'll ride the elevator back down and we'll start taking care of dudes. There are 10 guards plus, I don't know exactly what triggers the box guard to drop in. I think it's when enough of the guys themselves have dropped, or, you know, it might be location-based, too. I'll just have to see. But I'm gonna take care of everything down here. Okay, we're down. All right. I think it's fairly obvious that I need to start with the snipers. Be easier if I could knock him down.
I've got you covered.
Oh, dang it. If someone over there, if I can get someone to see me up here next to the sniper, they might just come and stand next to him. That'd be the easiest thing. But I'm not quite sure how to make that happen. What I'd really like to do is pull one guy up from that threesome, but I don't see that happening either. Whoever saw me isn't going to come up here. Which leads me to believe I'm going to have to do a trick that the editor-in-chief of the wiki actually showed me for dealing with snipers, which is that I can actually knock them down if I throw something heavy at them. Then once they're down on the lower level, I can get rid of them with a double takedown.
Thank you. as it was nothing. That was weird.
See if I can get him up here. Crud, he bumped me. And here I thought I was so close to getting what I wanted.
If anyone's here, come out now.
Oh, perfect. Perfect, perfect. Yeah, I was worried about that, though. I can't have him go off the cliff like that. Don't throw anyone over the edge this time, Adam. Oh, that's much better. That one's got a concussion grenade. How are they seeing it? No, I'm confused. I thought I was in gold just then. Somebody is seeing something. This is unacceptable. Who's actually seeing it, I wonder?
Oh.
I don't understand how they're seeing me. Or who is seeing me. I think that's my main problem, is not knowing. Not knowing who my issue is.
Enough of this.
What are you doing here?
Now I just need to get them together. Come on, boys. Tighten up. No. Finally. That one's got some sniper rifle ammo. That's all well and good. That one's still got his concussion grenade. For now, I should be able to leave the two of them here. That leaves me with 8 guys to deal with. Doing on nutrients. 2 bars, 2 packs, 2 jars. That's not a lot. Truth be told. I got 2 normal soldiers up here. I'm pretty sure there's another sniper 1 level above where I am now. Figure out how to get to him. Yeah, he's up there. And there's the ladder that goes to him. I'm pretty sure this guy just stands still over here, so I should be able to pull the other soldier on this level over to him. Who is seeing them? And how? Combat rifle ammo and nothing. Well, let's just wait for everybody to settle again. As long as they can't find their way over here, there's really not anything to worry about. I don't know why my cooldown timer just reset, though. Oh, did somebody find the other two bodies? They must have.
Someone's running.
Someone must have found the other two bodies. Need to hide them better, I think. In fact, let's run back over and do that before we do anything else. Of course, it's hard for me to think of anywhere better than right here, but there must be somewhere. Maybe I'll put them in the elevator, take them all the way out of here. Then they should be safe from discovery. Somebody saw something. That should be okay, though. I can pull them out of here and then just wait for the alert. This is a process I hope I don't have to repeat. Anyway, 8 bad guys now. Wait for that 15 seconds to run out. I gotta admit, as much as it doesn't actually add anything, I kinda like the cooldown timer. Alright, everyone is settled. Let's go arrange that same double takedown I pulled off before. I can, anyway.
Stop right there!
Yeah, this one just stays here, so I'm gonna have to wait for his patrol to cycle back. And I let myself go AFK, thinking I'd be fine. Obviously not. What I do wonder is who eventually moves. Or was I just not properly covered and got spotted by the guy I'm trying to lure over here? As I'm scoping things out, it becomes actually pretty obvious what I'm gonna do. You see that heavy rifle guy standing over there? Right now, he's just about in the center of the screen. After I deal with the two guys on this middle level, and, you know, hide the bodies, wait out any alerts it causes, I'm going to knock the sniper down next to him, and I should be able to deal with them using a double takedown. But because the throw will make so much noise, I think I need to get rid of everybody else first. Maybe I should deal with the ground level guys first. Seems like it might be easier at any rate.
I saw that.
Oh, I was gonna say, it really seems like it shouldn't be too hard to pull this wall leaner into the path of the patroller.
You hear someone jumping around over there? Go see what's going on.
Yeah, this shouldn't be this hard. It's probably easier or cleaner. If I pull the patroller to the standing guy. Rather than trying to go the other way around.
What the hell is-
The trick is gonna be getting right next to the standing guy without getting spotted. That shouldn't be that tough. I just come here and wait for that guy to turn and see me.
here. Come out now.
I think you're seeing things.
I've got a man down here.
Kill the bastard.
Damn it. I can't do anything without somebody spotting it, it seems like. Maybe I should do the other side first. One of my initial goals was to pull one guy out of this threesome so I could take down the other two. But I'm sure these upper level guys will see me do this takedown if they're still standing. Yeah, I knew it. I just can't tell who the problem is. I guess they're all problems just because there's so many of them, but... maybe I had the right instinct. I should get these guys next. And then just wait out any alerts. Who saw me? No, seriously, who? And why wasn't there an alarm gap? Again, straight to hostel. No alarmed in between. What is this garbage? The guy on... okay. Well, now I say the guy on the ground level is seeing me, but he's also jumping straight to hostile. That time, the target guy didn't see me. This is just bothersome. I'll make it work eventually. Keyword being eventually, because it's starting to seem like it might take a while. My big question now is why I can't seem to pull anybody. They just zip straight into hostile mode.
What the hell is that?
There's no alarmed interim period anymore. That's not good.
I heard something. Let me check it out.
Go see what's going on. You hear someone jumping around over there? You hear anything?
Go see what's going on.
You hear anything?
I already know this isn't gonna work, but... Or maybe it will. That one's got nothing. And this one's got... Well, he's got a Cyber Boost Pro Energy jar, which is welcome because I'm starting to run low on nutrients. But I still can't get those guys. Until I've dealt at minimum with the guys on the second level. With those bottom level guys out of the picture, maybe I can do this part at least. Yeah, anyone who sees me is still jumping straight into hostile mode.
Nothing. Someone there.
Stop right there!
This is gonna spell big trouble for me. Oh boy. Damn it! Wasn't paying attention, ran out of energy. I just can't quite cloak long enough. If I could just visually pull this guy over here, that'd be so much easier. I can't.
Hello?
You hear that? I'll check on it.
Go see what's going on.
I think maybe something a little more direct is called for. Let me try. Oh, why not use some of this concussion stuff I've been saving up? That's too extreme. Oh, that brought the sniper down. There's something to be said for that, I guess. I need the two guys on this level to see it, and nobody else. I think I can actually swing that. Yeah. Have to be careful. More careful than that. Okay, come on now. There you go. He's got nothing. He's got some combat rifle ammo. Now I should be able to wait out the sniper. No one else is alerted. And until I knock him down, the sniper is pretty constrained in his movements. Which hopefully means he's in no danger of finding those two. Everyone is settled. This is good. Let's see if we can get these two standing guys. Just gonna wait for the sniper to face the other way, and I should be able to get them. Leaves two. All I need to do now is knock the sniper down. 251 credits, 315 credits, and a gas grenade. Now let's see about that sniper. Obviously, a well-placed concussion grenade can make him fall down. Is definitely useful to know. Especially if there's nothing I can throw at him, and it looks like there's not.
No.
That sent him the wrong direction. I just need him to fall down to ground level. Still not good enough, huh? Nope. Seems like all the concussion grenades in the world aren't gonna work to send him down the other way. So I am gonna need to get something up there that I can throw at him and knock him down with. Because I can't lure anyone up to him because he's up a ladder. Is there anything heavy? I don't know. By the way, if we go down here, we get a 300-point exploration bonus, along with an EMP grenade and a frag grenade. So that actually is very useful. As far as something heavy, I don't think a regular crate. Dumpsters, here we go. Those will work. Need to get it up there.
I've had enough of this.
Did he spot me? I guess maybe he did.
Guess it was nothing.
Let's just wait for him to head back over there, which he will do eventually. He's on his way now, he's just taking his time about it. Well, that's what we need to do. Then we just need them to, you know, wind up together. Except he didn't go down that time. Need him to fall all the way down. Like he still doesn't want to go. I'm gonna be unhappy if this actually struggles to work after getting it the first time. Let's get a little closer. Maybe that'll do the trick. Cannot seem to knock him down. There he goes. By that time, the other guy has found some bodies. Come on. I thought for sure I had him that time. But like he was going, and then the game just yanked him back. There he goes. Oh, but that killed him. Can't have that either. I can't kill him. Hey, that got me a praxis point. With that one, I guess I'll get recoil compensation too, and turn my cybernetic arm prosthesis green. Now, my next question is, how do I trigger the box guard? I need to get him too. Now, that one's got 375 credits. I'm almost out of nutrients. I've got three jars, and that's it. This one's got 512 credits, plus some heavy rifle ammo. Now, how about that box guard? I have a gnawing suspicion that I have to draw the box guard out during the firefight with Malik, or else it's not gonna come. It's certainly acting like that's the case, isn't it? Yeah, no sign of the box guard, no matter what I do. I was worried about that. That basically means I have to start over. Because the box guard ain't coming. Well, that sucks. That just sucks. But we gotta do what we gotta do.
Malik, we've got company.
I know, but the bird took some damage. Gonna need to patch it up before I can go.
I'll stay and cover you.
Negative. You need to get away from here and find Dr. Savchenko. I'll be fine.
You'll be a sitting duck.
Maybe, maybe not. But this is your best chance to slip by them unnoticed, and you know it. So get out of here, Jensen.
Well, now the box guard is there.
You out of here yet, spy boy?
Malik?
Just find Vasily. Jensen, keep him safe.
Bye-bye, asshole!
Go to hell.
You bastard! Farida!
Oh, I haven't seen that before.
Surround him and take him down.
Roger that, sir. He has to be around here.
That was Narhari Khan.
Jensen, I've been monitoring comm activity around Hengsha. Belltower's looking for you. Hard.
Bastards ambushed us, Pritchard. Malik didn't make it.
Oh, God. I know you might want to get even. But if they see you, if they recognize you, it might be better to stay out of their way.
Oh, and it didn't give me ghost that time either. Probably because I got hit while I was running across the yard. Well, I wish I could... I wish I could just pull in the box guard. Like, getting to this spot like I can during the fight, but... That doesn't seem to be the way it works. Alright, yeah, let's start over again. Start by pulling the box guard into the fight. I'll be a little more careful about it this time.
I'm gonna need to patch it up before I can go.
I'll stay and cover you.
Negative! You need to get away from here and find Dr. Savchenko. I'll be fine!
Don't be a sitting duck.
Maybe, maybe not. But this is your best chance to slip by them unnoticed, and you know it. So get out of here, Jensen.
Oh, there comes the box guard.
You out of here yet, spy boy?
Malik?
Just find Vasily. Jensen, keep him safe.
Bye-bye, asshole!
Go to hell.
You bastard! Farina!
Round him and take him down!
Roger that, sir. He has to be around here.
Jensen, I've been monitoring comm activity around Hengsha. Belltower's looking for you.
Alright, let's try this again,
bastards,
see if it gives me ghosts.
Richard. Malik didn't make it.
Oh, God. I know you might want to get even, but if they see you, if they recognize you, it might be better to stay out of their way.
There we go. Getting things done and ghost. And the box guard has deployed. Now that's done, I'll go ahead and make another new save. And get started. Sorry, folks, but at least I have a better idea what I'm doing this time. The order in which I need to do things and whatnot. I have 2 bars, 5 packs, and 4 jars. I'd like to use fewer nutrients this time, if that's possible. And I think it should be... If I manage to... not let them spot bodies. Well, I don't want to let them see the robot explode either. Now that I think of it, that's probably... That's probably just as bad as letting him see a body. Oh, this part. This stinking part. Now I'd like to know why everyone just went hostile again. Have I found another bug? I think I have. They're all wailing on a chopper that's already been destroyed. Dang, I was going to be so happy with that. Someone else is spotting me. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and say that went awesomely. I got 8 other dudes and a box guard to worry about. Dang it. Oh. Might actually be easier to get up there this way by just hopping up the dumpster and then letting the guy see me like I was originally trying to do. Come on over here. That's good.
Nothing yet.
That's good. That's exactly what I want. And then there were 6, plus the robot. Actually, it's going to be much easier to approach from the ground level, I think. That in mind. Let's see what kind of groupings we have down here.
What the hell is that?
Well, everyone's going straight to hostile mode again. Even though no one, I don't think anyone has seen bodies or anything like that. Maybe they have. Oh, somebody found those bodies. Are you fucking kidding me? Who found those guys? Shit! Sorry. This is getting so annoying. Sorry, viewers. It's really starting to make me angry. Yeah, once they find a body or, you know, see someone get attacked or whatever, then you lose the ability to reel people in visually, if you know what I mean. They just jump straight into hostile status. Well, apparently it can happen now, too. Oh, and there I thought I was doing so well, and without me even noticing, somebody was finding these bodies. Bringing them all back. I don't know what's happening. I guess it's just that there are too many variables and I can't keep track of them all, but somebody's coming up here.
Who the hell is that?
I'm crouched, so I'm not making noise. No one is seeing me. Honestly, who is spotting me? This is insane.
I knew someone was here.
Thank you. Okay.
Who the hell is that?
Shoot. Jeez, it's no good. I'm gonna have to load from the beginning again. Oh my gosh! This is insane! Nothing works! Nowhere is safe! I'd like to not have to do this elevator ride again, so... I'm gonna start by updating the new permasave, and then... God damn, but this is hard. Just nothing works. It's like I can't isolate anybody. Not really. Everything is inside of everything. Oh my god! Who saw me then? Seriously! I'm getting so frustrated, folks. I'm sorry. Oh, let's just take a breath.
Thank you.
Okay, well... I think I've got an idea about how to revise my first move.
Stop right there.
And I need more energy. That guy up on the second level is the one who was spotting me, for what that's worth.
Something is going on. Is he anything? Stay alert. Nothing yet. He's around here somewhere.
Oh, that would have been perfect, but... They spotted me.
Tell me you saw that. See anything? What the hell is that?
Damn. First, let's let him spot me. He's gonna come over here. I'm tracking the other guy on the radar. Alright, I think that was finally a solid first move. Now, where to hide the bodies? That's the second big question. The next thing I want to do... Well, I don't want to let that timer tick down too far, or I won't be able to do it. Because it only works when they're on alert. But... I want to pull that guy up to the sniper like I've been trying to do as a first move. But he's gonna run right past these bodies as things stand. I need a place to stash them. That's not gonna work. It might work if I actually stash them up the stairs. But I definitely need to be careful with that option. Not interested in the combat rifle. There's no one down here I have to be afraid of. That's the good news. I got 8 guys plus the box guard. Well, everyone's settled. I didn't exactly want that, but everything actually seems really stable right now. Let's start with what makes the most sense. Oh, good Lord. Since we're here, let's go ahead and drop down here.
I think it came from around here.
Oh yeah, and let's turn on jump land silently. There we go. Let's go ahead and get the 300 points for crawling in here. Now that I've got this new equilibrium, let's go ahead and do that. I think the basics of what I need to do now are the same as last time. Although they're easier. Easier with the heavy rifle guy gone, but harder in terms of the last one after I knock down the sniper. I'll worry about all that when I need to. For now, oh hey, 2 Cyber Boost Pro Energy bars. It's good, I need those. He doesn't want to come investigate. And now he wants to go hostile.
You see anything? See anything?
There, now he's coming. He's gonna head back to his wall. My hope is that they'll pass close enough together for me to engineer a takedown. And I think they will. I was worried about that. The box guard is a big new complicating factor. That time, Jensen did a single just because he likes to make things hard on me. Convinced that's the only reason he would ever do such a foolish thing. Oh good, we're in the clear. Let's just pull them through here, then we'll really be in the clear. Nothing. And the jar, which we so desperately need. Okay. With that done, Let's head up to level 2. And take care of those guys. Same way we have so many times already. Actually used my ability to run silent just then, and that was pretty handy. I keep forgetting that Aug even exists in this game, which is, of course, extremely silly of me. That was beautiful. Now we're left with two guys in the box guard. And I'm left with the question of whether to blow the box guard first or knock down the sniper first. And I just don't know the right answer to that question. I'm gonna blow the box guard first. I think it's time to do that now. Because I think I'll lose my ability to visually reel guys in after they see the explosion, but I don't need that ability to perform this takedown anyway.
Activate self-destruct sequence.
Wait and see if everyone will settle down, because I think they will. Okay, everyone has settled down.
Sounds like someone running. If anyone's here, come out now.
Oh, well, let's get our dumpster ready to go. Make sure I didn't accidentally kill either of these guys. In fact, I should make sure everyone is still alive. Oh, he's on another long alert. That's okay with me, though. Let's go check on the four bodies up here. Oh my god. Damn it. Oh well. Let's try again. That's gonna have killed those guys, and I can't have that. Come on, Jensen. I just need you to get the dumpster up there. You can do it. Attaboy. That's what I'm talking about. Perfect. Those four are alive. Let me make sure the other four are still alive. Not that I have any reason to really have any reason to think they wouldn't be. But, with exploding box guards, surrounded by explosive barrels, it pays to be careful. Since we are hoping for pacifist at the end of this. Alright. Now we need to get the dumpster up to level 3. He's coming this way, so I'll need to wait for his patrol to cycle. One thing that's a little funny to me about knocking this guy down, and really any knockdown, is that I know that fall would absolutely kill Jensen if he didn't have Icarus. And it doesn't kill any of these dudes, but I don't see any of them deploy an Icarus system either.
No one's here. Why am I jumping at shadows?
So I guess Jensen's just ultra weak. Okay. Well, he's behaving strangely because I don't think he normally stands halfway off the edge like that.
Huh? What's that?
I need to do something to get him back through the dumpster.
No one's here. Why am I jumping at shadows?
That's better. Now we're up here with the dumpster, just about ready to knock him down. I think he's not moving because the dumpster's right on his normal patrol spot.
That was weird.
Let's pull him over here. Get the dumpster out of the way.
Because it was nothing.
Now, suddenly, I think we're ready. He's down. We're down.
Let's get him!
He's on the run!
Suppression fire! I heard that. Come out.
Come on, fellas.
Where is he? Come on, show your face.
He's on the run!
Get out here.
Actually, I've got a different idea. I want to see what he does after falling, if I don't do anything else.
Let's get him! Come on, show your face! I heard that.
Well, that turned out to be easy. Okay. After all that, I think we're done. Got the ghost bonus. Think I got this exploration bonus, let's just be certain. I got the box guard. I got all five available double takedowns. Now, finally, we're free to loot the construction site. So let's do exactly that. Whew! Time for another big save. Alright, what's over here? Nothing. We're under where we started right now. I see no goodies over here. What about the platform where we started? There's more stuff I could have thrown up here, but I don't actually see anything. Over here, I already got the two Cyber Boost Pro Energy bars. Other than that, there's nothing there. I don't see anything out here in the middle. I don't see anything here. Over here, there are two boxes of heavy rifle ammo, if you're into that. Up here, we've got sniper rifle ammo. That's all. Over here, I don't really see anything. Let's check the ground level on this side. Got a whole lot of nothing. Let's check under this tower. Nothing. Let me sweep the second level right quick. Nothing. I do think I can get one level higher. Maybe. Yes. But it looks like there's nothing up here. So let's take the elevator out. Finally got all those guys down. Well, after all that, after several false starts and a lot of anger and frustration, for which I apologize, we're clear. So for maximum XP, you want to let Malik die, but if you're going for achievements, you need to save her at least once and then reload. 10 soldiers, 5 available double takedowns, 1 box guard you need to make sure you get, 1 exploration bonus in that electrified pool down there, and finally, a getting things done bonus and a ghost bonus. Oh, I'm seeing nothing up here. Let's exit to Lower Hengsha. Once you use this door, you will not be able to return. Are you sure you want to leave? Yes. Okay, folks, thank you for your patience, and again, I do apologize for losing my temper swearing at the game. There's the most serious instance of the glitch so far, and as you can see, we're not the only people it affected. But I'm not going to worry about any of that right now. That triggered the autosave, and so I'm going to say that's good. So I'm going to make my new permasave right there, and I'm going to thank you for watching and say this has been Let's Play Deus Ex Human Revolution. We finally got through the construction site. Next time we'll do the second visit to Hengsha. Until then, bye-bye.